Good day, everyone. Today we will continue with the exterior body panels. On a first glance, it looks like we are closing in on the finish line for this part. But I've gone through and looked at the reference and written down all the things that are left to do. And those are pop rivets for the Seuss fasteners here. You also have to make the actual Seuss fastener. We have to make a lot of body panel rivets as well. See here, around the edges. We need to make a Lotus emblem. We also need to make flathead screws for the side door here. I have no idea what it's for, these small doors here, but they should have flathead screws on them at least. We need to make X bolts for these holes in here. I think you can see it. Here. And we also need to make a hole this panel here so that we can access the bolt that holds the upper control arm for the suspension. We can see that this ref image supposed to be a hole. That's it. I'm just gonna try to power through and see how many of the things that I can finish on this sitting. So I'm going to start with the Seuss fasteners. Found a good blueprint for one here, so I'm just gonna take that into Maya and make one of them. Position it in the center of the scene, which makes it a lot easier to work with symmetry. It's symmetrical both in X and Y axis. That's going to make it pretty easy. Just going to scale this correct. We have some measurements here. The overall width is 3.7 centimeters basically. Cube. Scale the blueprint down. I'm not going to be millimeter or a tenth of a millimeter perfect. That's good enough for me. With the cylinder. Remove half, mirror it over. It's going to be 0.56 millimeters thick. Not going to bother with the exact measurements for that, so I'm just going to make it look very thin. The pop rivets are going to cover these holes, so I don't need to model them in. But I am going to clean this up a bit. We should look at the ref, and we can see that there's supposed to be a hole that goes down inside. We want to have that as well. Actually gonna remove the bottom part for now. Gonna need that anyway. Like so. Remove the caps. Scale it. Touch down. Since I made this shape from a cylinder with the same amount of edges or segments as this one, I could actually remove this top part that I made. Bring these together. I need to invert this part or reverse it. And be able to do a bridge. Maybe not. Probably needs a hole to be able to bridge it. I'll just do it manually. Now I could do this, but it's not going to keep shape very well. Now I'm going to remove this part. Well, I would like to have edge here and here, so that this part stays straight. That's going to mess up the circle in the middle, so remove that. This is going to be a better topology. Turret together. The other direction. Looking at the blueprint here, we can see the angle this is supposed to have. Just gonna eyeball it because it's not super important. See down there. Use this as a starting point. Make the screw. Slightly smaller, and have it follow the same angle, basically. I would like to have some more segments on this so that I can cut this flat cutout in the middle. I'm gonna crease this edge here and give it one smooth. Decrease. I think that's fine. Actually, I'm gonna give us a nice edge there to catch some highlights. The part is flat. Really sharp edges on these. That inside of that we're going to or cut out. Pretty deep one. I want to count the edges here so it lines up with the middle ones. Have 1, 2, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4. So we're going to have to go that. Be fine. Put it in the middle here and just do one side and mirror it over. Looks good to me. Since this is a completely flat surface, it doesn't matter if topology is a bit off. It's all going to be flat anyway. There we have it. Now all we need to do with this is chamfer. Could actually add that. issues here. Clean that up. This edge looks a bit too sharp, so maybe we are to remove part like that. I think that looks better. I'd have to do that. Enough. And now we're going to do the pop rivets. Start with the sphere. The size is kind of unknown, so I'm going to look at reference. You see here in this image here, pop rivet is going to cover quite big part. That looks pretty good. Delete half of it. Bit big to me. That looks good. Just make it go as far down as it could. Have it This. Top rivet. Whenever you do these generic things like screws and rivets and stuff like that, make sure that you save them out to your personal library and you can reuse them later for another project. I do have some screws that I already made in the past, but for this project I'm going to remake all of the screws just for the sake of documentation. And copy that over. And the SUS fastener is done. I'm just going to check in which orientation the middle screw is supposed to be when it's locked. This image here, you can see that it's turned slightly. These SUS fastener work. You turn them basically 45 degrees, I think, to lock and unlock. Better. It's hard to find, but I would think that it's locked in this position that it's in right now. Let's say this. Go ahead and place that. See here that it's supposed to be three of them, and here we can actually see that it's straight locked. Oh, there's going to be one in the absolute middle. They are fairly close to the edge. So, one on each side. Basically, a fastener's width from the edge, and maybe a little bit more. Just gonna down to the edge. There. Good position. Good. Turn that over. Always nice to get these small details in. Sells the scale very well. Actually like to have the screw screwed down so that we can see it through the bonnet here, or the nose cone. We could take this. We're never going to see inside here, so. But it would be nice to catch that small highlight. The middle part doesn't need that treatment. This one is the same. Mirror, move the other. It. Now we need to make a small cutout in nose cone here so it doesn't intersect with the Suze fastener. To do that, we would need to smooth it once more. And again, delete the middle. Tab. Keep it as simple as possible. Enough. Everything back together again. Looks good. So that was the pop rivets, Seuss fastener. And let's move on to the emblem. Be pretty cool to make, I reckon. Most of this stuff is going to be done by texturing, so I just need to model the actual shape of the emblem. I'm going to start with a sphere again, move the bottom half, scale it to size. Very far forward in the blueprint, so probably going to have to look at some of the refs. Not the end of the world. Where I place this right now, good. Iterate on it later when we make the textures. Somewhere around here, I think. Basically flat like that. Gonna leave that. Remember to name your models as well. Bone, those fasteners. Let's move on. We have body panel rivets. I'm gonna do them last, I think. Would be a good idea to fix this hole that we talked about here. So we have this mock-up of the suspension here. Basically gonna make a copy of that. Move it over. It. Color. That way we know where to put our hole. I did notice the Lotus 49B have the same setup in the that here. Just gonna be even smaller than that. Do some of this. Guessing it's gonna be basically the same size hole as the rear here. That looks good to me. Probably don't need so many segments. Half of this maybe. Line up good. Trying to figure out the easiest way to place this. Could cheat it a bit and put it slightly higher than it's supposed to be. That I could just I use my usual manual cutting technique. Still haven't found a good way to do this automatically. I'm gonna put a bolt in here, even probably never going to be seen. After I smooth things, I like to go in and tweak the geometry a bit. So. Bit nicer. Have a nice hole, that screw or bolt in there. Again. Let's look at flat head screws for this part here. See that here. Pretty. Start with a sphere again. As long as the proportions are good, it doesn't matter the size when we work on it. Gonna delete more of the sphere. I want that curvature. Pretty good. Round off the bottom. Gonna try out. Yeah, I want this cut out to be fairly thin. That. And remove half. Top view, I can just make a cut. should be a very sharp edge on this. Work out fine. Sometimes it can be good to make the angle of the bottom. It's deeper like this to if it's supposed to sit on a curved surface. Have this tool called SP Paint 3D. Pretty old tool, done by Sebastian Pavio, it seems, in 2009. It's a simple, like, mesh paint script. I'm gonna use this to place the rivets on the car, and I can use it to place these screws as well, because it's quicker to use it since it aligns the mesh to the surface underneath. So all I have to do is select the the screw and add it as a paint, a brush geometry here. Add this. Add this as a target surface. Then if I press place. You can see that it rotates according to the surface underneath. That's a very quick way to place things. And I also think that we can like to know if we can make it the new surfaces parent to this, so if I scale this, every other one is scaling. Be nice. Yeah. We can also make a random rotate on the Y axis. So minimum 0, maximum 180, so we get variation. Doesn't really matter, we can scale it. To scale them by object. Just gonna have to find a good view where I can see four of them, see the size a bit better. That looks pretty good. Maybe slightly smaller. Move them out. Towards the edge a bit more. So, okay, so 0.5. I'm gonna replace these. And this one's 0.5. Place them again. Bit easier. Good. Okay. Rotate it. Pretty nice. So when things near completion, you're gonna notice that they become pretty dense. I like to smooth them so that I don't have to apply a lot of smoothing in render time. Since I will take this into Substance Painter later as well, I need to have a certain level of smoothing going in before I paint. This is fine. So we have the hex bolts for this hole here, and then we have the rivets for the body. Don't really like the way that these polygons stretch out here. See it in the shading that it becomes bulgier. Have to fix that. Fix. Manually go in and place. Do the same for this. So it keeps distance a bit better. Bit smoother now. I'm gonna have to adjust this as well. Looks a lot better. Okay. Oh, let's make X bolt. Again, the size that I work in is not super important. Make sure that the proportions within the object look good, and then we can scale it later. Hex bolt has hexagonal hole in the middle. That, and the outer part is supposed to be round. So I'm going to make a quick calculation here, since I want this to be keep this shape when I smooth it. It's gonna have to look something like this later on, and that's gonna give us 3 times 6. That's 18 sides. So I want this to have 18. That way I can actually start. In fact, I don't need this cylinder at all, I just realized. I can make it this. Then I can just circularize this one. No. Bit sharp that. Now we have a nice hexagonal hole middle of the round one. Bolt. Be a bit smaller than this. Usually the outside bit of a curve to it. Looks pretty good. Once, there we have it. Actually forgot to save out one of the flathead screws here, so. Hold on, didn't. Oh, it's actually here. Place both of these in a group called screws. Screws and bolts. That way it's going to be easy for me to find them later. So what I should have done here is actually UV map these before start placing them out on the car, because there are going to be several of them past the UV, the one original one. So I'm going to go through UV mapping later as well. But at this point, I'm just going to do it quickly for these. Objects. I start with applying a camera-based UV so I get no seams. And then I usually place one seam here. One going that way. Should be enough. Doesn't have to be perfect. I unfold it. Some solution on it. It doesn't matter what kind of pixel density it has right now. Just want to unfold the bits. That's done, and then we have this screw. Flathead screw, place one seam there, and that's going to be enough. Hold it. Sit. I already placed those here, so I guess I'm going to have to bite the bullet later and UV map those, but it was such a simple the UV map. I won't bother. That's it. I'm going to make a copy of this. Make sure that it has the same angle, basically. Hole. Put it roughly in the middle. Then try to find the ref and see how big it's supposed to be. Almost as big as the hole, so that. Down a bit. It's actually going to be very dark in there, so I don't know if I need to even add any panels or anything. Could be a good idea. It's probably bolted to a frame. The inside, and you can never see it, even in daylight, so. Otherwise, I usually put like a box behind, just make it black. Actually looks like it's slightly offset, and that could be a nice detail. That. Copy that over. So now that we go into the UVs, we just lay out and then flip the ones that are red. Then we don't have to unfold everything again. So that's it. We have hex bolts. I think the only thing left now is body panel rivets. So I have a bit of a dilemma here with the rivets. I've been thinking about them a lot. You can see they're supposed to be riveted in raw metal and then painted over, so you get this nice you can see the thickness of the paint that it actually covers the bottom of the rivet. It's going to be very hard to make unless I make it with a displacement map. Or if I tessellate the hell out of it and add those in ZBrush or something. And I don't want to do that. So I think I'm going to take the middle road and I'm going to accept that going to look like the rivet is placed after it was painted. But I'm going to add this bulge down in the body panel on each rivet in the bump map in Substance Painter later. So at this point, I'm just going to model one rivet, then populate it all around the body. And then the rest is going to be taken care of in the texturing process. See, this is a good photo to the size. It looks like they are a bit flat on top. Some are not. It's going to be good enough to have this. Same thing here, I want the bottom to reach down a bit so I'm safe over any curvature. Good. Let's take this. It compared to the whole. Pretty good size, actually. This hole might be too big, actually. I'm not gonna sit and place everyone like this. I just want to. Something works. I think the size is pretty good on these. Happy with the size. Oh, I'm going to go into the SP Paint tool again. We are going to place. Probably no rivets on the nose cone. There's plenty on the main body. I'm gonna have to take one part at a time and just find the best reference image for that area because there are rivets. A good image. Start with this area, I think. And I'm just gonna work on half the body and then mirror everything over. So this is gonna be target surface, and then we have the rivet in geometry. A random rotation doesn't matter since it's symmetrical. Yeah. Just gonna go around our placing. Hold on, I want these. Of course, I want these as objects as well. Add those. Start placing. Now that not what I expected. Ended up inside. So I'm probably gonna have to find these. Now if I place something here, it looks better. Five of not sure if I'm happy with curvature here. Go back. Look. Now that's not good enough. Remake that. Just a case of moving a bit. way here. I think I can control the curvature here better this way. Trying some different things. it. Oh, did not think about this part being different to the other one, so I have actually removed stuff that I needed. I'm gonna have to bring that back. So I had to go back to an earlier version of the file. I always use the incremental saves, so I have a backup if I make mistakes like that. Should be safe to. And good. It'd be quicker now that I know what I want to make. Good. Finally, get on with the rivets. Okay, let's start over. I like this method because it gives some variation in the placement. I would just copy one of these, it would be very straight looking. A lot of work to just move things around. Get a unique look. Sure if they are too big actually. See what happens if we scale them down a tiny bit. Even more, I think. Or maybe 0.8. Looks a bit better. Scale-wise. Go with that. Scale this rivet down 0.8. So the next ones I place will better. Same for this. Try to work fast. Have it. Around this hole is so 1/4. Quite hard to see what's going on, so I'm just gonna add what feels logical to me, basically. At this point, I'm using the wireframe on the mesh as a guide. Keep even distance. It's gonna look nice to have these as a mesh. Give that little extra depth. There's no need to UV map a simple mesh like this before I start to duplicate them, because they don't need any seams at all. I just unwrap them with no seams and it's perfectly fine. There's no extra job skipping them. Just noticed we need another set of bolts for this one. It's fine. On. I'm going to add the screws and bolts on this backside when I make the engine and stuff, so that I know where all the engine mounting points are. I don't have a lot to say right now, just keep working on getting these rivets out. think I've gone through all of the body panel rivets now. Gonna double check. Starting to look pretty cool. Looks like there are more rivets around the screen here than what I've made. I could use the paint feature and just drag out with similar distance, but for this method most often. At least when I want something placed very precisely. That looks better. That's it. That's maybe was one. Yeah, there's supposed to be rivets across here. I think that's it for the exterior body panels. Only thing left are the screws, maybe, for this part here. Again. We also need to make rivets for part down here. Let's do that first. no idea what this looks like in real life. These areas are very hard to find reference on, but we see that there are rivets around basically every theme. I'm just add rivets. Look cool. It from the bottom, I think. There are going to be so many things around here, so I'm going to bother with extreme precision. Yeah. I'm going to make these bolts here. Then that's it for the external body panel. eyeballing this right now. Make a quick UV map here as well. Looks like they are it. Right, I think that's it for the body panels. Thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.